Так, у вас здесь кнопка есть
микрофон.
Включить или выключить микрофон. То есть когда можете выключать микрофон, чтобы лишних звуков никакие вы не передавались. Ну, в общем, сами будете включать или выключать. Как вам удобно.
На как называется сессия? Nano Science и Nano Material же, да?
Совершенно.
Да. А вообще, Nano Technology.
То есть сейчас у вас микрофон включен.
Hello, everybody. Let me to start our session on nanoscience and nanotechnology. We have four presentations. Let me to remind you that the invited presentation, duration of invited presentation is 20 minutes. Plus 5 minutes for questions. As to ordinary presentation, duration of presentation is 15 minutes plus 5 minutes. Okay. The first presentation is invited reporter from Любовь Герасимова. You can start.
Hello, everyone. Can I start the presentation?
Yes.
Okay. So, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I am Gerasimov Lubov, and I would like to present my report, Non-Dispersive Carbon Black Production, Biopyrolysis of Hydrocarbons, which has been prepared by me and my colleague. The carbon black is one of the oldest products by human. The term carbon black is a generic name that uses not various industrial products, such as chemical, thermal, etc. Acetylene duct and furnace source, which mainly are composed of elemental carbon. So, carbon black is a polydispersed substance. Due to its properties, size, shape, and physical chemical properties, it is widely used in an industry as fills, pigments, and reinforcing agent in rubber and plastic. It gives protection from ultraviolet radiation, electroconductivity, and the range of darkness and opacity for elastomers, paints, and plastics. In addition, nanoscale soot has been acknowledged as advanced material for the creation of fuel cell electrodes, storage batteries, polymer fills, and nanocomposite composite of solar cell. So, the classified carbon black production process into two main groups, in complete combustions and thermal decomposition of hydrocarbons, depending on the absence and occurrence of oxygen. Furnace black method, in the oil furnace process, an aromatic liquid hydrocarbon feedstock is heated and injected continually into the combustion zone of a natural gas-fired furnace, where it is decomposition to form carbon black. Carbon black production by the lump black process is one of the oldest. It belongs to the process of thermal oxidative decomposition and characterized by great simplicity. The feedstock required is an aromatic oil mainly based on the coal tar. The process is not very flexible. It deals with a given set of equipment. Sorry, I mixed up pictures of furnace black process and lump black process. And thermal black process, this is method is cycle with natural gas is the most commonly used feedstock through higher grade hydrocarbons oils and also used. It consists of two reactors operating in cycles. One is heated with a natural gas or oil and air mixture, while the other a bit with pure feedstock which undergoes thermal decomposition. And the electric arc process, today is one of the environmentally friendly methods to mine one of the most perspective technologies. So, one second. So, it deals with the ability to provide energy temperature by external energy supply, which cannot be achieved with the combustion method and a very short dynamic response, limited environmental impact, also in addition, the ability to carry out the process in various atmospheres. You can see the main advantages on the slide. So, the main goal of my work, it is producing the final dispersed carbon black using a plasma chemical reactor based on three-phase egg plasmatron operating on ortho-xylene and argon. And the main text, it is a study of the electric arc pyrolysis of ortho-xylene and investigating physical and chemical properties of resulting carbon black. So, the scheme of high voltage free phase plasma torch presented on the slide. The plasma torch is powered by a power source with an open circuit voltage. It consists of a C-type transformer, current limiting reactors, reactive power compensator, and a system of measuring electric parameters. And the plasma torch is made in the shape of three interesting electric arc channels with graphite rod electrodes. Also, I want to describe several stages of arc method. The first, it is providing direct contact of electrodes, which is necessary for ignition of the arc. The second stage, it is setting the distance between the electrodes, which should be constant in order to ensure stable arc burning. The third, it is the arc powered by a direct current, provides the evaporation of hydrocarbons at the anode. And later, under the influence of a high temperature, the hydrocarbon evaporates in the inert gas atmosphere, which the formation of soot. And later, soot condenses on the cold walls of the refrigerator. During pyrolysis and chemical bonds of organic materials are completely destroyed. At the final stage, gases with high hydrogen content and nano-sized particles of soot are obtained. So, one second. так, the plasma torch diagram is shown on the slide. Also, you can see. Так, sorry. Okay. The initial ignition of electric arc carries out in the gap between the electrode and the plasma torch and enclosure. Under the action of a plasma-forming gas stream, argon, an electric arc is blown to the periphery of the electric arc channel. There, it locks with the same arc from the adjacent channel. Sorry, autoxylene vapor is tangentially supplied into the middle part of the electric arc channel. Such a supply of hydrocarbon prevents the formation of carbon black in the near electrode region and carbon deposition of the electron inclusions. The main parameter of this process you can see on the slide. So, to determine the specific area and porosity of high dispersed solids or system having developed porosity absorption is absorption isotopes. For carbon black, we used a single point method and the method BET. And the graph characteristics of the porosity you can see on the figure 1 and 2. And also you can see the main results. And in addition, the middle size of carbon black is 60.7 nanometers. Also, on the next slide, you can see the structure of carbon black, which it taken take from SEM microphotography. So, carbon black samples were studied by dynamic light scattering in order to obtain information on the particle size of carbon black. In the samples, two fractions of distinguished with a maximum about 150 nanometers and 500 nanometers. The largest particle have size about 2 microns. It is probably due to the different mechanism of formation of these particles. Smaller soot is formed during the pyrolysis of octoxylene, and larger soot is formed during erosion of graphite electrodes. So, the degree of crystallinity was estimated from the data of X-ray diffractometry. The diffractogram has peaks a week in intensity appear clearly identifiable and presumably related to polarimotic hydrocarbons and possibly fullerene or fullerene substance. The high intense peak is attributive of graphite residues. The IRA spectra of soot extract allows the conclusion about the presence of various polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, such as naphthalene, phenolphthalein, fluorine, and benzenpyrene. The element analysis showed that the extract does not contain any elements except carbon and hydrogen and adsorbent gases. Based on the average atomic mass fraction of elemental, it can be assumed that the presence of aromatic polynuclear hydrocarbons. So, in conclusion, I would like to draw your attention to findings, I don't want to read it. Okay, so let me now finish my report. Thank you very much for your attention. Your question, please, if it is possible in Russian. I don't hear you.
Sorry. Thank you very much. Good presentation. We are waiting for questions from chat. Some moments.
А где я могу найти чат?
Я
нашел уже.
Пока нету, да?
Maybe you have a question.
I have one question. Maybe in Russian. Maybe in...
I will glad.
I will translate it.
Well, ваши частицы являются нечистыми частицами. Они содержат водород.
Yes, yes. Your particles are not pure particles. They contain hydrogen.
Thank you. Какие пути вы можете использовать для того, чтобы получить частицы чистого углерода?
What ways can you use to get pure particles of carbon? Carbon pure particles.
For example, the method of gas chromatography. And also maybe you can use a cyclone.
Cyclone.
I forgot how in English it's called.
Cyclone.
Cyclone, sorry. I'm finished.
Okay, thank you. Any questions from chat? Let me to thank you and your presentation.
Maybe I have one question. Why have I a status of invited? Invited status. Почему мне статус приглашенного не интересно?
Не понял, почему?
Почему мне приглашенный стоит?
Your presentation is invited presentation. I see in my program that your presentation is invited.
А с чем это связано? Не знаю.
Maybe mistake, I don't know so. But your presentation is nice, and all is nice. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Написано, наверное, вы победили в конкурсе тезисов.
Maybe you have won in the competition of
tesis.
No, it's wrong.
It's wrong.
Okay, thank you for response.
We can go to next presentation from Nikolai Sirotkin. The presentation is invited. Duration of your presentation is 5 minutes, 15 minutes. Sorry. And plus 5 minutes for questions. Some moments. Николай Сироткин, please start your presentation.
Thank you. You hear me?
Yes, well.
It's excellent. dear colleagues, I present to your attention a report on the topic the use of plasma solution systems for producing metal and metal oxides nanoparticles with photocatalytic activity. In accordance with a roadmap for the development of box and plasma physics and its applications, the study of discharge in liquids and contacts with liquids is one of the priority areas. Interest in such discharge is due to the practical applications, including the destruction of organic compounds in water and water disinfections, modifications of polymeric materials, quantitative spectral analysis of solutions, as well as the formations of micro and nanostructures. The rapid growth of the number of publications devoted to the problems confirms the interest in this topic. In the slide, you can see the possible combinations of plasma solution systems used to obtain nanoparticles. A DC discharge with liquid electrodes and electrode located above the surface of the solutions is often used. These methods of implementary of plasma solution systems is characterized by the simplicity of organizations and control, the ability to work of atmospheric pressure and efficient temperature. Nanoparticles of palladium, silver, gold can be obtained in the process of anodic distillations of the corresponding metal electrodes immersed in the liquid solutions in contact with the plasma. When using discharge with the two electrodes located in the liquid, the formation of plasmas is possible in vapor gas bubbles arising as a result of local overheating of solutions near the electrodes. Or the formation of plasmas streams is possible. In this case, the destruction of the electrodes and and the subsequent dispersion of nanoparticles is a liquid occur, accompanied by the rapid quenching. At present, at present, nanoparticles of wide range metals on the oxides have been obtained by plasma solution methods. Primarily nanoparticles of silver, gold, and other noble metals. Nanoparticles of these metals have unique properties that ensure their widespread practical applications. In a number of works, nanoparticles of metals and metal oxides with magnetic properties have been obtained. This includes nanoparticles of nickel, cobalt, iron, and iron oxides. In addition, the nanoparticles of copper, zinc, cadmium, silver, platinum nanoparticles, and carbon particles were obtained. Of particular interest are oxides of refractory metals. these oxides have unique properties, and the oxides of these metals are used as photocatalyzed, photochromic and neutronic materials, as well as in production of lithium-ion batteries and lead-emitting diodes. Nanoparticles of molybdenum and tungsten oxides have bacterial properties and can be used to destroy cancer cells. Thus, the use of plasma discharge in contact with liquids is a promising method for obtaining nanoparticles of various metals, nonmetals, and oxides. However, a number of problems, including the preparation of nanoparticles of a given size, prevention of agglomeration, and the possibility of embolizations of nanoparticles on polymer materials, require further research. The main aim of our work was to establish the irregularities of the formation of metal oxide nanoparticles using the discharge contact with liquids. And then the photocatalytic properties of metal oxide nanoparticles we examined for the hydrogen's photocatalysis on different dyes. We have tested various ways of organizing plant polymer systems to obtain nanoparticles. In the first case, discharge is ignited between an anode made of metal wire, for example, of molybdenum wire, and the distilled water used as cathode. The action of discharge leads to non-equilibrium evaporation of water, sputtering of metal anode, and formation of molybdenum oxide. In this case, particles of alpha molybdenum oxide are deposited on the metal anode, and aqueous dispersion of metal of particles of molybdenum oxide is formed in liquid cathode. Since the synthesis of molybdenum trioxide takes place in plasma with the liquid, it is reasonable to use emission spectroscopy for characterizations of these processes. This figure presented the optical emission spectrum of glow discharge with electrode cathode. The most intensive bands were represented by the molecules of nitrogen, molecules of nitrogen oxides, hydroxyl radicals. Also, you can see the atomic oxygen lines, hydrogen lines, and the several lines of molybdenum atoms. By the using of DLS method, the particle diameters is about 160 nanometers. And the absorption spectra of aqueous dispersion of particles were used to calculate the band gap of the obtained particles, which have semiconducting properties. For this, the tau equation was used. And the calculated band gap is from 3.2 to 3.4 electron volt. The phase and crystal structure of obtained molybdenum trioxide nanoparticles were examined by X-ray diffraction analysis. And in this figure, you can see the X-ray diffraction pattern. So in the gas phase, we obtained alpha molybdenum trioxide particles, and in the liquid phase, we have ash molybdenum trioxide particles. This conclusion confirms the IR spectroscopy. And here you can see the same images of samples. In the second case, the discharge unit between the metal molybdenum cathode and anode of distilled water was used. The sputtering of molybdenum cathode begins after 3 seconds, and the color of the discharge changed to bright yellow. The process of forming of dispersion of molybdenum oxide particles in the water anode begins after 5 seconds. During the burn of discharge, the cathode oxidate and change its shape. Thus, it can be assumed that the formation of molybdenum oxide particles occurs in the plasma. And here you can see the similar analysis for these particles. For this process, you can see the emission spectra of the discharge, particle size distributions, and absorption spectra of aqueous dispersions, and calculated band gap. The powder was analyzed by scanning electron microscopy. The particles have size about 140 nanometers, and this form was a cylinder and prisms. The EDX analysis shows oxygen and molybdenum signals only, and the molybdenum oxygen atomic ratio was determined to be 1:4, and it reasonable expect that it is a mixture of oxides and also called non-stoichiometric oxide. And our assumptions confirmed by the results of X-ray diffraction analysis, which indicates that the compositions of the sample includes molybdenum oxygen 3, molybdenum oxygen 2, and molybdenum 4, oxygen 11. And these conclusions confirm the XPS spectra of molybdenum particles, molybdenum oxide particles. Here you can see the process this occur in the liquid anode. The molybdenum ion reduced to the molybdenum ion 4+ in the reactions with the heated electrons. And you can see the change color of the aqueous dispersions. And here in the figure you can see the tip of the molybdenum wire after the discharge burning. In the last case, we used electrodes placed in water. High car density leads to overheating of the solutions and the formations to the steam bubbles, which leads to the break the electron circuit. This leads to collapse on the bubble with the excitation acoustic wave. As a result, the electrodes evaporate and thermally excites in the water vapor, and occurs the formation of nanoparticles. The waveform of the current and voltage of the underwater discharge is shown on this figure. The average pulse duration is about 4 microseconds. And the discharge can be called a pulsate excited by the constant current source. And here you can see the emission spectra of the discharge and particle size distributions and absorption spectra of aqueous dispersion. In this case, we obtained the non-stoichiometric molybdenum oxide. You can see the same image of the sample, X-ray patterns of the sample, and IR spectra of the sample. The same experiment was made to obtain tungsten oxide nanoparticles. Tungsten oxide particles were synthesized under similar conditions. In this case, gamma tungsten oxide particles is formed. However, the size of resulting particles and the band gap are slightly different. And the emission spectra of discharge contained lines of tungsten atoms. Here you can see the analysis of these particles, including them. The average size of particles is about 200 nanometers. Then you can see the summary table shows the characteristics of obtained particles depending on the methods of production. Attention should be paid to the energy costs of obtained oxides. To obtain results of energy consumptions are comparable with the results of the synthesis of metal oxides in using nanosecond plasma. In addition, the power of the discharge is lower than the power of arc and microwave discharge, which used for the synthesis of tungsten oxide particles or molybdenum particles. And the low values of the band gap and high values of the specific surface area make it possible to use the obtained compounds as efficient photocatalysts. And photocatalyst activity of synthesis particles were studied under the UF and visible light radiations after dark absorptions. The removal efficiency of the dyes on molybdenum oxide and tungsten oxide particles is presented in this figure. The experimental results show the a regular decrease in the efficiency of the photocatalytic decomposition of dyes during the transitions from UF to visible radiations. The less efficiency of the dyes removal of molybdenum oxide particles can be explained by the difference in the band gap values for tungsten oxide particles. Despite this, the photocatalytic activity is quite high. Thus, the following can be said as conclusions. We propose a simple and efficient method for the obtained nanoparticles of refractory metals using plasma of atmospheric pressure of discharge in contact with liquids. The resulting oxides have a low band gap and high specific area and can be used as effective photocatalysts for removing various organic pollutants. And more information about our results you can find in our published works. Thank you for attention.
Thank you.
Thank you for your presentation. We are waiting some questions from chat.
There is a question in the chat. Which of the presented methods for obtaining nanoparticles has the highest productivity and why?
So the highest rates of particle formations is observed in a glow discharge with the liquid anode and the metal cathode. But what's the reason of this fact? It is very hard questions, and in our further studies we can try answer to this question.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you.
One more question.
I can answer that. Yes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. From Mikhail Yusupov.
Okay. Okay. In all experiments, distilled water used as liquid. Only distilled water, without any additives.
Okay, thank you. Mm-hmm. I have one question.
Okay.
Could you tell us some words about bactericidal activity, bactericidal properties of your particles, oxide particles?
Okay, now we obtained the first results, but we have one problem, because these particles can and should be coated on the polymer or tissue, polymer on tissue coating. And our first experiments, we have strong bacterial activities against different bacteria, for example, E. coli and other. So I can see you. Wait a minute. And you can see the bacterial activity about different bacteria of our nanoparticles. It is the particles of tungsten oxide.
What metals?
Tungsten oxides. Tungsten.
Yes, thank you. Thank you. Next questions. The question is ending. Thank you very much. Your presentation is end. And now we have a short announcement from organizing committee.
Okay,
we are waiting some minutes. Yes. We are waiting for announcement from organizing committee. Yes.
Давайте следующий доклад он после этого будет.
Окей. We start the next presentation from Мария Киселева, young person from Ural Federal University, Екатеринбург. Мария, 15 minutes for your presentation. Thank you. You can start.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Мария Киселева. I would like to present you a paper entitled Production and Characterization of Composite Nanopowders on Silver-Coated Aluminum by a Radiation Chemical Method. In recent years...
Sorry, could you tell loudly?
...due to their wide range of properties. Among them, one can underline antifungal, antiviral, antimicrobial, and antiseptic properties. And naturally, anti-tumor activities is very important. With covering the surface of particles with the other nanoparticles, it is possible to improve the properties of compound and expand the range of applications of composite nanoparticles. One of the prospective applications of silver nanoparticles in medicine is their combination with various substances. It allows to get a complex effect of the composite elements and to save silver. The usage of silver-based composite in combination with anti-tumor drugs is prospective in the treatment of angiogenic diseases such as cancer, in joint dental transplantology, for directed bone tissue regeneration, as a photocatalytic agent for water disinfection, as well as in target drug delivery. The purpose of this work is to produce and to study the properties of aluminum oxide coated with silver, as well as to assess the prospects of using this system in the medical and pharmaceutical field. To achieve this goal, the following tasks were formulated: to study the literature on the research topic, to develop a method for preparing a stable suspension for obtaining the nanopowder, to get a composite nanopowder and investigate its properties, to investigate the toxicity of the composite in relation to cell cultures, to investigate the photocatalytic properties of the nanopowder. And the relevance of the work is to obtain silver nanopowders and composite based on them to create new materials for development of new methods for treatment of various diseases and pathologies, as well as for development of biotechnologies. For the first experiments devoted to silver coating and aluminum oxide nanopowder was selected. The radiation chemical technology for producing silver nanopowder was used as a basis method. After irradiating with a nanosecond electron beam and with using solution based on polyatomic alcohols, they can be obtaining the smallest variant of silver particles. The composition of the solution and its irradiation conditions are shown on the slide. After irradiation with a nanosecond electron beam, the suspension was divided into two parts. In the first case, the deposition time of silver nanoparticles on the base took 15 hours, and in the second variant, it took 4 days. In accordance with microscopic analysis, the size of the nanoparticles was 50 and 80 nanometers, respectively. On the slide, you can see that the areas are in the turn in two states, distributed in fragments in a thin layer, or complicated and completely surrounded the surface of aluminum oxide. The degree of silver coating of the base for large powder was from 16 to 40%, for small powder from 2 to 3%. The preparation of composites was complicated by the fact that aluminum oxide is insoluble in water and is distributed homogeneously in the suspension. The stability of the suspension is characterized by sedimentation stability, which is directly proportional to the optical density. To obtain a more uniform coating, were used sodium citrate and polyethylene glycol. Measurements of the optical density of suspension showed that the rate of nanopowder deposition immediately after ultrasonication, the decrease was 8% for the control sample, and for the suspension with PEG and sodium citrate, 1 and 0% respectively. However, after the study in 24 hours, the powder deposition was 99, 76 and 86% respectively. Therefore, it's necessary to continue search of a stabilizer. In addition, when interacting with ultrasound, each suspension changed its color. The color sample and the suspension with an addition of PEG became gray-brown, and the suspension with sodium citrate, mustard. The concentration of silver ions was determined by the method of radiometry, which is based on the specified chemical reaction. This reaction you can see on the slide. The appearance of a different color can be explained by a different size of the particles formed during the reaction. Now let's move on to antibacterial activities. The methods were used to study the antibacterial properties of the composite nanopowder. Cell counting using the Zagarev's chamber and the disk diffusion method. Wine yeast was used as cell cultures for the first method. In each series of experiments, one of the plates was a control group, and each of the remaining ones was added with 1 microgram and 2 microgram of nanoparticles, aluminium oxide, silver, large composite, and small composite in the first and the second series of the experiment, respectively. The number of nanoparticles at the bottom of each plate was 1 microgram per square centimeter for the first series of experiments and 2 microgram per square centimeter for the second series. The antibacterial capacity was evaluated in 24, 48, and 72 hours. The antibacterial properties of the composite are superior to those of the base powder in silver at both concentration. Moreover, the larger composite has a greater biological activity in comparison with the small one. While studying the composite, we observed that the antibacterial properties depend in a complex way on the concentration. At a concentration of 100 microgram per square centimeter, the biological effectiveness decreased with increasing exposure time. This is shown in the left diagram. And at a concentration of 200, we observed opposite situation in the right diagram. The antibacterial properties of nanopowder were tested against Escherichia coli and Staphylococcus aureus using the second method. Colon bacillus and Staphylococcus are the biological markers of environmental contamination. Moreover, Staphylococcus refers to sanitary indicative microorganism. It was found that the bactericidal effect was not detected for aluminium oxide. Weak activity of the studied bacteria was recorded for silver and composite. To evaluate the photocatalytic properties, methyl violet was used as a water pollution simulator. The dependence of methyl violet photodegradation from the ultraviolet radiation time can be described with a linear equation, in which the coefficient near to arguments characterizes the rate of discoloration of the solution. A research result showed that a concentration of 1 microgram per microgram per milliliter, all powders act as photoprotectors. At a concentration of 480 microgram per milliliter, on the contrary, the photocatalysts and the composite showed their greatest efficiency. To summarize, I would like to pay your attention on conclusion of my presentation. First of all, I sufficiently high efficiency of the method to produce composite nanoparticles was established. The ability to control the deposition process and the type of silver coating on aluminium oxide nanopowder by changing the deposition time was achieved. While studying the stabilization properties of nanopowder before irradiation, It was found that the use of stabilizer such as sodium citrate and PEG was limited. The antibacterial capacity of nanopowder was tested on the yeast, corn bacillus and staphylococcus. And finally, the photocatalytic properties of the larger composite were tested. They demonstrate prospects of using the composite as a photocatalyst. Our research continues, and the direction of further research are presented on the slide. Investigation of the properties of other oxide coated with silver, finding suitable stabilizer for a more uniform coating, continue investigation of photocatalytic properties of nanopowder for water purification and disinfection, investigation of nanopowder cytotoxicity influence on human cells, investigation into tumor properties of nanopowder for usage as an agent for target drug delivery, investigation of antibacterial properties of nanopowder for usage as a coating for dental implants. Thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer them.
Maria, thank you very much for your very useful report. We are waiting for some questions for you. Я задам вам вопрос на русском.
I will ask you in Russian.
По поводу серебра.
About the silver.
Которое обладает антибактериальными свойствами. Это хорошо известно.
Which has the antibacterial properties. It is well known.
Но серебро должно быть в небольших концентрациях, потому что серебро действует не только на вредные бактерии, микробы, но и также воздействует на полезные организмы.
Because it affects not only useful microbes, but, sorry, could you repeat, please?
Серебро воздействует не только на бактерии и микробы, вредные для нас, но и на полезные организмы.
Uh-huh. It affects not only bacteria, but also useful particles in organism.
Как здесь найти золотую середину?
How to choose the best way in this case?
Слушаем вас. Listen you. The question is complex. I know.
We need to get into a certain concentration window where we can kill bacteria and not harm the body. This is difficult, it's true. And now we find the method where we can find this concentration. I think it is experiment very long, but we know that the concentration was very small, because if we have mm-hmm. big concentration, we will harm our organism.
Okay, thank you. Next questions. No questions. Your report is finishing. Thank you very much. I can't talk.
Thank you very much.
We start no somebody from organizing committee. Start the last presentation from Евразийский национальный университет, из Казахстана, Ди Алма Даулетбекова. You can start. Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Не слышно?
Yes, very well.
Здравствуйте, уважаемые участники конференции. Предоставляю вашему вниманию доклад.
Good afternoon, dear participants. I am presenting my report.
Формирование нанокристаллов на основе цинка селена с использованием трековой технологии.
Formation of nanocrystal based on zinc xylene compounds using track technology.
Актуальность исследования связана с получением новых нанокластеров с использованием трековых темплейтов.
The relevance of the study is due to getting nanoclusters using electrochemical and chemical depositions.
Перспективным методом формирования новых нанокомпозитных материалов
The method of forming nanocomposite materials.
Да, да. На основе методом темплейтного синтеза. В нашей работе
based on the method of template synthesis.
Методом темплейтного синтеза были получены нанокристаллы цинк-селен 2O5.
We got crystal cir-selen 2O5.
Стоит отметить, что по данному кристаллу практически отсутствуют литературные источники, что не позволяет нам выявить уровень исследования его структурных и оптических свойств.
Literary resources are almost absent. And it doesn't allow us to identify the properties.
На фоне бурного развития нанотехнологий в последние десятилетия можно констатировать факт повышенного интереса к оксидным наноструктурам, в том числе и к наноструктурам цинк-селен 2O5.
We should state the fact that there is a great interest to nanoclusters.
В этой связи целью данной работы является синтез и исследование нанокластеров цинк-селен 2O5 с помощью электрохимического и химического осаждения в трековый темплейт ASIO2CN.
In this regard, the purpose of the study is to synthesize zinc-selenium 2O5 nanoclusters using the electrochemical and chemical depositions.
Структура СО2 на С облучались ионами ксенона с энергией 200 мегаэлектронвольт на этом циклотроне до C60 до флюенсов 10 в степени 8 ионов в сантиметр квадрат.
On this cyclotron, fluence is 10 to the power of 8 ions per centimeter to the extent of 2.
Для вот определения морфологии и поверхности облученных структур СО2 на С кремниевая подложка была подвергнута химическому травлению, который показан на рисунке на слайде.
You can see on the slide that the silicon is shown here.
Химическое травление образцов СО2 на С проводилось в 4% водном растворе H-TOR. В состав травителя входил палладий массой 0,025 граммов. После химического травления проводилась ультразвуковая очистка поверхности в течение 15 минут.
We have conducted different experiments and we have added chemical compositions. So for the concentrations of 0.4%.
В следующем слайде представлены методы получения нанокристаллов цинк-селен 2O5 методом электрохимического и химического осаждения.
This slide shows electrochemical and chemical depositions at room temperature.
Показаны следующий состав электролита для электрохимического осаждения.
The following Также composition electrolytes are shown here as well as.
Электрохимическое осаждение проводилось напряжение 1,25 вольтов, а время осаждения 15 минут, а химическое осаждение в течение часа.
Chemical sedimentation was due to the hour.
Поверхностные свойства были
исследованы с помощью сканирующей электронной микроскопии, которая показана на слайде. Также представлены поперечные сколы, исследованы с помощью растровой электронной микроскопии.
You can see on the slide which were performed with the help of the method electroscopy method.
Были получены диаметр на напор от 291 до 356 нанометров.
The diameter was from 300. Once again, will you repeat the diameter? 291 up to 356 years.
Для определения структуры вещества был применен метод рентгеноструктурного анализа, который показан на слайде.
X-ray structural analysis method was conducted, which is shown on the slide.
Результаты рентгеноструктурного анализа для темплейтов после электрохимического и химического осаждения показали создание нанокристаллов цинксилен-2О5 с орторомбической кристаллической структурой пространственной группой ПБСН-60.
X-ray analysis results showed for zinc selenium 205 samples showed the grown on CO2 pure CN substrate.
Полученные нами параметры элементарной ячейки, они совпадают с литературными данными, что показывает нам результат эксперимента.
The data coincide with the literature data and which show us.
На этом слайде показаны теоретические расчеты нанокристаллов цинк-селен-2О5
shows the theoretical calculations
с использованием программы Crystal.
Using the Crystal program.
Так. Здесь показано А, это элементарная ячейка цинк-селен-2О5, которая состоит из 32 атомов, а на правой рисунке представлены результаты распределения электронов в кристалле.
Left figure shows us the elementary cell, and on the right we can see the distribution of nanocrystals.
Видно, что вот атомы связаны и имеется химическое взаимодействие на связях, то есть кристалл является ионным, значительным содержанием ковалентности.
So covalency in crystal is shown in this figure.
В этих облаках, вот электронные облака, показано, что приблизительная заселенность связи составляет приблизительно 0,15 электрона.
Approximately it shows us 0.15 electrons.
На этом таблице представлены наши результаты. Это параметры ячейки, это теоретические расчеты, это наш эксперимент, а это эксперимент другой работы. Видно хорошая сходимость всех результатов. Говорит, что хорошая корреляция наблюдается как в теоретическом, так и экспериментальном методе.
Okay, so the table shows us the work, our work calculations, our experiments, the results of the experiments, and good correlation is observed here.
На этом рисунке, на В-рисунке, была построена плотность состояния и также зонная структура. Здесь видно, что запрещенная зона 2,8 электронвольт близко к другому расчетному показателю.
The density of crystal shown in letter C, yes, here, and the forbidden, запрещенная, once again, will you repeat, please?
Из расчетов видно, что кристалл является прямозонным. У него наименьшая запрещенная зона, которая находится в гамма-точке.
Okay, the forbidden zone is in hammer point.
В эксперименте также наблюдается, что кинетика достаточно хорошая, электроны там быстро переходят запрещенную и становятся свободным.
Kinetics is very good, electrons go through and become free.
Это говорит о том, что это прямозонный кристалл.
This is about the issue that this zone is crystal.
Таким образом, В настоящей работе методом электрохимического и химического осаждения были получены осаждения в трековый темплейт АСИО-2СН, были получены нанокристаллы цинк-селен-2О5 с артробической структурой.
Mm-hmm. In this regard, just a minute, please. In this regard, zinc, diselenate zinc C2O5 were obtained by electrochemical and chemical depositions.
Также установлено, что при осаждении наблюдается высокая степень аморфизации, что кристаллическая фаза диселенцинка формируется при напряжении 1,25 вольтов, это при электрохимическом напряжении, и в течение часа в химическом осаждении.
Uh-huh. When electrochemical sedimentation, we observe the nanoparticles of 0.25 hundredths.
Thank you for your attention.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Questions?
Thank you. My questions is, you are Alma or not? What's your name? Hello?
Можно повторить вопрос, пожалуйста?
Я задаю вам вопрос. Вы докладчик. Ваше имя не Алма. Кто вы?
Я когда вначале представилась, я докторантка Даулетбековой Алмы Кадиновны.
Она Алексей. No,
назовите свою фамилию, пожалуйста.
Акубекова Алма.
Все, спасибо большое.
Thank you very much.
We are waiting for questions from chat. Здесь где включить? Ага. No questions. Thank you very much for your presentation. Very fruitful presentation. Thank you.
Uh-huh. Thank you.
Dear colleagues, our session is finishing now. Thank you for your participants, and that's all.